Welcome to fourth video of career guidance, my dear friends. In this video, I will be telling you the course that you can take after 10th and what will be the career paths after 12th. And there are certain career paths which does not restrict itself to any specific stream. You can be from arts stream or commerce or science. So anybody can choose certain career paths, and what are those and what are the prospects? Let us see that. And the career paths that will be discussed, that has been discussed in this video on economics. So we know we are very much familiar, and in fact we are very much blessed to have a good number of economists in this country. Nobel laureate Amartya Sen, Kaushik Basu, Manmohan Singh, P.R. Brahmananda. Likewise, there are many, many economists are there, and they are the living legends at present, right? So, and you can also become a person like Amartya Sen, Manmohan Singh, or Subramanya Swami. There are many people like that. Okay, you can become by studying the economics or literature, journalism, and India is known for this, right? There are many journalism streams. Investigation journalism is also one of the important journalism, and if you are very curious, we can also become a journalist. Social welfare, fine arts, physical education, psychology, law, design, in that fashion design and other designs as well, in general design, hotel management, tours and travel management. So these career paths are been discussed. So if you have any doubts on this, right, please leave your questions under comment section. I'll come back to you with the answers if it is possible to answer. Have a nice time. Now let us take arts combination after 10th. So if you have taken arts as a combination after 10th, then the possible combinations are, along with the two languages, English and other language like Hindi, Kannada, etc., other languages, right? So you will be having four optional subjects: history, economics, political science, sociology. One combination, these are all the combinations: history, economics, optional Kannada and sociology, history, economics, geography and political science, history, economics, geography and optional Kannada, economics, sociology, political science and psychology, history, economics, logic and psychology, history, economics, Kannada, that is optional Kannada, and Hindustani music. These are all the other combinations. There are other set of combinations that can be taken after 10th for the PUC, that is 11th and 12th, first year and second year PUC. These are the combination along with the two subjects. Then after that, after completing 12th, right, then the possible courses are, that is after that, what is after that is the question. After this, you can take BA, right, the BA is a degree, right. So when you take the BA, right, the Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Arts, so there are different combinations possible for this, right. So there, along with the two languages, so there will be three options. Instead of four, there will be three options that are possible, that will be there, right. So if you take Bachelor of Arts, right, and this combination, arts combination after 10th is considered as easy combination for the easy going students, and also BA is also a easy going subject, and the degree, that is to say, and that means the people can easily clear this BA examination. That's what the general opinion is. Now here in this Bachelor of Arts, so the jobs and career that you can face after BA, you can do the BEd for the teaching profession. And after BA, you can do Master in Arts or MA and EMET, right? And you can get into teaching at the banking sector, right? If you have taken economics as a major there in the undergraduate course, right? So in the BA, if you take economics as a major, then you can become a teacher by doing MA in economics. And also, you can get into banking sector. At present, there is a dearth for the economics lecturers in teaching profession. And also, economists are most important and necessary for the maintenance of the country, right, and for the welfare of the community. And for that, economics graduates are more important and more essential, and there is a dearth for it, right. So there are, that's why most of the private university like Azim Premji University, Shivanadar University and other private universities have come out with the BA in economics major, right. So that is one of the best combination. And these people will be doing, what they do in their career is, they will be, if you take BA, you will be doing teaching, or you can do pursue academic research, you can get into administrative services, administrative positions, especially if you take sociology or history or geography, you can get into civil services UPSC examination and take get into either IAS or IPS or exams for that. And also if you are in economics, you can be in a planning division, right? So these are all the possible careers and the work that you are going to do if you take BA as a degree. And the salary would be, will starting salary is 1 to 2 lakh per annum, and again it depends upon the course that you have taken. There are vast combinations and the courses and the careers which are there, from banking to the teaching, right? Of course the teaching is really good for from school to the primary school to the school. You can do teaching, right? There is definitely a good number of teachers are required for the community. Next is a BA in psychology, right? The psychology is the major, right? Here I told you about the psychology that can be taken in the PUC, that is 11th and 12th, and you can continue that with the psychology major. And you can, if you do that, be a psychology or a main psychology, and the role of you is, you will be a psychologist, the person will be a psychologist, you can be a counselor, counseling, and also you can be a HR executive, so that you can plan what is good for the organization, and you can design a curriculum, you can train the people, you can train the employees there, so that they can get rid of their negative attitude, and by that they can be more helpful to the organization. So you will be there as an HR executive or a trainer or a counselor, and you can be a good psychologist, and then the profession could be teaching. And again, here again, the salary varies from 1 to 2 lakh, and details can be seen in the next slide. Next is BSW, Bachelor of Social Welfare, and this is another important graduation course for the arts graduates, right, those who have taken this. And you can be a social welfare officer, counselor, and you can be in a healthcare sector. Majority of the BSW and MSW, right, after BSW, they do the master's in social welfare, and majority of them are in healthcare sector and also in community development. Their role in the community development is very important. So their role in the socio-economical improvement of socio-economical conditions of the society is most important. For that, the social welfare graduates becomes a more important personnel. And they can develop a cognitive and psychoanalytical techniques. So they will be the people in developing these techniques and helping the wealth of the community, right? They are like a people who can uplift the economically weaker or socio-economical conditions. Those socio-economic conditions poor, they can be uplifted with the help of these community officers and social welfare officers, right? So they are the people who will be bridging between the executive body and the people, right, the general mass, right? So they will be like a bridge between the two and help them in overcoming their problems. And the salary varies from 2 to 3 lakhs, that is a beginner salary. So these are all the three important course, right? Of course, these two are same course, but here it is psychology. And in this case, one important thing is, right, if you are a science graduate, this could be wonderful, because during this analysis, right, when you are in the counseling to develop a psychoanalytic technique, this also will be there in it. And for that, statistics is one of the subjects that will be used as a tool for the analysis. So if you know, to a certain extent, if you are good in mathematics, this will help for the psychologist. The previous slide has given a picture about the courses that have been that could be taken here. And here in this case, if you want more information about the courses that you can access from this websites, and this will tell you about the courses, how, what the course would be, and in detail you can come to know about the BA course. And here this will tell you about the of course this is a Bachelor of Fine Arts, of course it doesn't suit here. And this website will tell you about the different combinations which are there in the BA, the different possible combinations. You can get it from this website, and this will tell you the salary. This website will tell you the salary of the graduates after completing BA, what could be their salary that can be obtained from this web portal. And this will tell you about the scope of this, and also the what are the further possibilities, right, after this, after graduation. What is the scope of this graduate course and the expected salary, right? So this can be obtained. And this is about the psychology, right? You should know the difference between BA in psychology and BS in psychology. There is a difference between this, right? And that can be known from it. One will be BS, it is more of a science, and this is about more of a psychological aspects of a human behavior, right? This will be about the neuroscience and the neurological aspects will be studied in this. and this can be known from this. The difference between the two can be known from this website. And this will tell you about what are the possibilities, right? What are there to, for a good psychiatrist, right? Why we are not having good number of psychiatrists in India, and that discussion is there in this site. Okay, next this will tell you about the careers that are possible with the BA in the psychology as the major, right? You can come to know the what are the possible career options, right? And this will tell you the what is the scope for the psychology degree in India in terms of available jobs without a master degree, right? Before the without doing the master degree, what are possible? So if you do the masters, that will be better, but even without that you can get, and that could be obtained from this report portal. And this is central, this is a psychological institute, a central institute of psychology in Ranchi, it is there. And there is one more in Bangalore, NIMHANS, and National Institute of Mental Health and Neurosciences, right? And also there is one more, the Behavioral Science Institute. These are all the three government institutes. In these you can do master's degree, and also you can pursue MPhil or doctorate, right? Especially NIMHANS is most sought after institute, right? Of course, these two are also these are the three important government organizations which are doing exceptionally well in terms of the research and the services to the mankind. And this is about BSW courses. What are the BSW colleges which are there and which are good, and what they actually what to actually do in it, right? That can be obtained from this. This will tell you about the again the social work guide, right? And this is what is there in different countries also, because the social work in different countries are different because the socio-economic conditions are different, countries are different. So there is, with this you can have a idea about the options which are there in other countries as well, US or UK or Europe, right? So that is possible there. And here this will what you can do with the BSW degree, right? That is career options can be obtained from this article, right? And this will tell you about what are the career options after BSW in India, right? This Quora is really a good source, and with this you can this will be from the first, this will be a first hand information. The person people who are in that field will share their opinion, you know. And this also tells about social work career, and this is another site, and this is again the scope and what is the expected salary, right? For the beginner and also for the experienced person can be obtained from this. And this is about the pay scale. These three will tell you about the pay scale which is there in the for this particular field, right? Other course for the students who have taken arts as the combination after 10th, and that too those students who have taken history, economics, optional Kannada, sociology, history, economics, English, sorry, Kannada and sociology, right? So for them there are many opportunities, right? So one is the BA in Kannada, the optional Kannada, and after that they can do AMA, that is master degree. Under undergraduation, if you do the BA, then you can do BA with BEd, right? BA BEd nowadays, now BA BEd integrated course is also possible. It's also coming up, and that is a 4-year course. BA is 3 years, MA is 2 years, and BA BEd is a 4-year course that is coming up. And if you do history, Kannada and political science, or history, Kannada and communication English, right? So if you do this combination, right, it will be good for a teacher. And also you can take up administrative service examinations, right? In fact, recently there are many people who have taken Kannada as a major, or Kannada or Tamil or Telugu as a major in UPSC examination, have cleared UPSC examination with a good distinction and top ranking, and become IAS officers, IPS officers, right? So Kannada is one of the best option for the people who are willing to take up administrative services, right? It has been proved that Kannada, Telugu, Tamil, Hindi, these language people who have taken that as an option major subject have cleared UPSC examinations. So this is one of the best course, right? And next is BA with English as the major, right? So English, if you take journalism, economics and English, and this as the combination in BA, or journalism, political science and economic, sorry, English, optional English as a major, then those will be wonderful personnel for the teaching profession, BA, BA. Or if you do MA, masters, you then also you can be in a teaching profession, and also you can get into administrative services. And with this journalism, economics and English, right, this is a wonderful combination for journalism, right? So for journalist students, right? So those who want to do the journalism, you can this is another who want to become journalist, this is one of the best combination. After this, if you do the mass communication program, masters in mass communication program, then that will be a wonderful option, right? The salary for them, these people will be 1 to 2 lakh. Of course, this is again depends, it all depends upon the community, what field that you have taken. So these are all the what the careers that is there for you. These are the things which these people with the BA in English or in English would be in there. Could be teacher, administrator, they could be in administration and also could be in journalism. And apart from that, they can be, right, the people with very good knowledge of Kannada or English, they can be a content writer. They can be people who can write for the content writing, right, with the knowledge of Kannada and the local language. And English is most important. So if you have this Kannada and communication English, that will be a wonderful option for them, for the content writing, right? Next option is BPED, Bachelor of Physical Education, right? So this is, these people will be doing, they will be involved in physical education. The teachers, they are basically teachers in physical education. So for the schools as well as the colleges, so they can be a director, physical education director or teacher, mentoring sports persons in schools, colleges and sports academy. So here the people with this BPED, there is a no even diploma course is also there, that is BPED. And after BPED, they can do the MPED course, so that is Master in Physical Education. The people who are good in sports, they can opt this, and they can be a trainers, they can be a coach, they can be event managers in sports. That's one of the important profession that can be taken up by the master graduates. There is a diploma course, there is a course available for them. So by doing that, they can become event manager for organizing sports events in national and international arena. And this is one of the best course for the people who are very much interested to pursue physical education, and they can be a trainers for the students and also other personnel. And the salary, again, it is only a representative salary, right? So details can be seen in the next slide. So these three are the another important combinations for the students who have taken arts as a combination after 10th, right? So after 12th, these are the possible, and after graduation, you can do the masters in the respective courses, right? So these are the possibilities for arts graduates. In the next slides, I have given the details about these combinations, these courses, and where you can get the more information can be obtained from there. In this slide, I have given information regarding the possibilities and what are the more informations that can be drawn for making the decisions, right? So this will tell you about the Kannada course, the BA in Kannada, right? What are there in that Kannada course, and how best, and what are the best universities, right? This is the another university which is there, right? And this is one of the government government organization, and this is the Kannada University, this is the Hampi, and this is Women's University, right? Women's University which is there in North Karnataka, right? For the Kannada graduation. And from this, you can come to know the salary for the people with the BA in Kannada in this website. And this will tell you about what to do the after bachelor's degree, what are the possibilities which you can do after Kannada MA and BA in Kannada, right? So this the website contains the details about it. And from this, you can get information about the BA English course, right? English major in BA, right? This will tell you the details about it. And this will tell you about the careers of path after BA, right? So this website will tell you, and this will tell you about the possibility of doing the BA in English in other universities, or English as a career in other countries as well, right? And this also tells about the possibilities of doing the course and the Oxford University, right, outside the country. And this will tell you about the pay scale and the pay that is there, that is salary for the graduates in English, right? And this is again English studies, and this will tell you about the top universities to pursue the English as a MA in English, right, for the master course. There are many universities from starting from JNU, Delhi University, right, Jamia Millia University, right. There are regional institutes in the different states, and they are all very very good universities and colleges which are teaching English as a subject, optional subject. and this will tell you about what are the best colleges to pursue master's degree in English literature in India, right? So there are many good institutes, and in fact the people with the knowledge of with the MBA in English are in great demand for, so they can be placed in any state for that matter, since there are medium of instruction is English, as well as the subject that I have studied is English, right? They can be in any state, irrespective of the local language, they can get a job in any state. That is an advantage. So this is about the BPED course, Bachelor of Physical Education course, and that details can be, more detail could be obtained from this. And then this also tell you about what this physical education teachers will do, and what are the vacancies, and where you can find the jobs, and is it worth pursuing BPED, that can be obtained from this. That is it worth pursuing, and that has been shared by the people who are in that field. And this will tell you about one of the best BPED colleges in Karnataka, that is in Mysore. It is run by the university itself, right? So that has a postgraduate center, right? And this will tell you the salary for the person who have pursued this, right? So this, now here are the special courses that are available after 10th. And after 10th, if you have chosen arts or science or commerce, any course or any stream, if you have chosen any stream, you can find a wonderful career in this stream. Let us see what they are. Now I'll tell you about the course, and that are very important. After 10th, if you have chosen either arts or commerce or science, you can choose any of these combinations, any of these undergraduate course. The first one is LLB, Legum Baccalaureacy, that means Bachelor of Law, that is the meaning of it, literal meaning of it. So if you are from an art stream, you can choose BLLB. If you are from commerce, you can choose BCom LLB, science, BSc LLB. And if you are, graduated from this, right, this is actually a dual degree. Earlier it used to be BA and then followed by LLB. Now there are integrated course available for BA LLB, BCom LLB. This is a 4-5 year course available, right, immediately after QC they can do it. Earlier it used to be after the graduation, undergraduation, there people used to do LLB. Now you can start doing it along with the BA, BCom or BSc. Right, and if you do this, the career that you can choose is either you can become an advocate or lawyer, a justice and legal advisor, or a consultant, or you can be an advisor, either civil advocate or criminal advocate, or you can be a consultant for the corporate. And what you do there is a legal advice. So this is what you give to the people, and by becoming that, right, you can be a wonderful advocate, a lawyer, and you can go up to, right, you can become a justice, right, you can become a jury. And also you can become an attorney, that is possible here. And here one important school or college which is very important is National Law School. There are many national law schools in the country. The one which is at Bangalore is the number one, it's considered to be number one in the country, right? For this, immediately after second PUC, you can take up the entrance examination for the National Law School. And if you get very good marks, right, you can get selected to the high priority institutes, right? And if you are graduated from National Law School, and you will be having high rewards in terms of remunerations, right? And of course, this is considered as one of the best option for the students who wish to do LLB. And here, I suggest the science graduates will be the most, normally the science graduates prefer this because mathematics is involved in that, right? And they can easily crack it very easily, right? So this is very important for the students who will be taking the law as the profession. Next is BFA, that is Bachelor of Fine Arts. So here this is more of a passion than a profession. If your passion is for the arts, then you can choose this, right? If you become that, so it here what you do here is you will be specialized in painting or sculpture or music or dance or photography, any of it, right? You can be an art director, you can be a painter, you can be a teacher, you can be about fine arts teacher in the school or a college or an organization. So all about the study of visual forms of arts. So that is what you normally do as a career, right? So here everything depends upon your passion for these forms of arts. So that is most important here. So, and here this being a self-employment, and of course there is a possibility of becoming a teacher, and it depends that the salary varies from 10,000 to 20,000, right, per month. And again, if you are a self-employed person, if till you make a name in this field, you will get less money. And if you once you make the name, then once you made the name for yourself, then your prospects in that field is more, right? So that is what the advantage of this BFA is, right? There are many art schools in India. There is a school of fine arts, and also there are many institutes that you can see it in the next slide. Next course is Bachelor of Journalism or Bachelor of Mass Communication. Those who want to pursue journalism as a profession, they can do this after 12th, and they can take this course, right? So there is BA in Journalism and also Bachelor of Journalism. So those two are two different. So there is also the course called BMC. So it's almost same, right? So if you choose this, and after completing this undergraduate course, you can become a journalist or a news editor, or you can become a personal PRO, personal relationship officer, right? So what you actually do there is you will be reporting, and you can be a content writer, right? You can be editor. If you are good in interviewing, you can do for the news channels, right? You can be a reporter, very good reporter, and also an interview the person and of high caliber. So there is one person, right? By doing the interview itself, that person has become a billionaire, right? That is possible. And she is from US, right? So most of you may be knowing her, right? And you can be a mass communication consultant, right? So this is possible with this degree, right? So more details of both the course content and the possibilities, what are the feasible options which are there in this course, could be obtained from the links which is given in the next slide. Here you can expect the details for the LLB, right? For the Legon Baccalaureate, right? So this website will tell you about the job opportunities for the law students after graduation, after completing the LLB. What are the opportunities that are there in the country that you can obtain from this web portal? And this is the best college that I mentioned, National Law School, right? The one in Bangalore is good. And for this, after 12th, you have to take the entrance examination called CLAT. Right, if you clear that with higher percentile, right, you can get selected in the NLS, right? This is one of the premier law institutes of the country. Next, and here are the job opportunities, right? What are the from opportunities for this that you can obtain from this? And this will tell you about the pay scale in the other countries also. In the US, you can, how much pay is there for that? What is the salary that you can obtain from this paidscale.com? And this will tell you about what are the opportunities after law, right? The opportunities next for what prospects of the law graduates could be obtained from this. More details could be obtained from that. This, whether this the LLB is a good course for developing a career in this field of law, that you can get it from this, right? There are many discussions happened here, right? That you can get it here. And the Quora is the best of place to find out whether what is the expected salary for the LLB graduate and what will be the future, right? That can be obtained from the Quora, right? Next, for the Bachelor of Fine Arts, right? The best college, one of the best college in Karnataka, that is in Mysore, that is called as Kava, that is Chamaraja Academy of Visual Arts, right? This is one of the best visual arts, and of course in Bangalore also there is there are very good visual arts academies, right, which are there, right? Chitrakala Parishad is one such. It is a government or semi-government organization. And the careers of Bachelor of careers with the BFA, what to do with the Bachelor's of Fine Arts degree, so what is after the Bachelor of Fine Arts, that can be obtained from this web portal. And Quora, again, it will tell about what are the some career options after studying the fine arts. So this will tell you about the career options which are there after the fine arts. Next, this will tell you about the opportunities and also training which are there in different countries and how they value this, that is there, and also course fee can be obtained from this. Next, this will tell you about the this payscale.com will tell you about the salary component involved in this BFA after completion. What will be the expected salary? It is an approximate value, it is not exact. Again, this BFA entirely depends upon individual's performance. Bachelor of degree, Journalism or Bachelor of Mass Communications, for this what are the degrees, where they are, where you can study, that you can best colleges where you can be trained from this, right? This is one of the college, Asian College of Journalism, right? The top universities, right? This will tell you about the courses which are there in journalism and how best. This will be a wonderful guide, right? And this will tell you which is the best government colleges offering bachelor degree in mass communication, right? So there are the government colleges, and also there are private colleges that you can obtain from this. The best colleges among private and government, what are the best colleges for that? so that you can obtain. And in fact, in these colleges, right, especially in government colleges, the fee will be very less, right? It varies from 10,000 to 80,000 rupees. It is very less, relatively less per annum, of course. And pay scale will tell, this will tell you the salary that you can expect. And again, here also, this depends upon the group with which you will be working, right? So this is one, and this is this will tell you the last one. This one will tell you the career path in the journalism, how best it is in India, and that these are all the details. So these web portals will give you, the websites will give you, tell you more about this these courses content and its prospects. Now I will give you another set of courses that could be taken after 12th. If you have chosen either arts or commerce or science after 10th, and after 12th you can choose this course, right? It is, there is no restriction for the courses that you have taken in the 12th. So here the first course is Bachelor of Design, and this is really a good course for a science graduate. So those who are really interested in designing aspect, especially fashion designing or interior designing and accessory designing, this is a wonder, or even jewelry designing, this or graphic designing, for these almost all these courses, science graduates are most preferred compared to arts or commerce, right? It doesn't mean that they cannot take there, but they can take, but a bit tougher course. And your job career jobs will be a designer. Your career option is a designer, basically you'll be a designer. And these are the things that you do: fashion designing, interior designing, these are the specializations, accessory designing, textile designing, jewelry designing, especially now this is one of the best course, right? Especially in India, right? So there are many models that are available in temples, right? So this jewel designing is another important course in India. Graphic designing, multimedia designing, VFS designing, right? This is in the multimedia sector, right? Then visual communication and game designing. So these are all in basically the multimedia sector, right? So these are the courses which are offered by NID, National Institute of Design, or NIFT, National Institute of Fashion Technology. It is exclusively for fashion technology. There are the wonderful organizations in India, right? And there are many companies who are hiring these the designers, right? In fact, campus selection will be very good in those NIDs and NIFT, right? National Institute of Design or National Institute of Fashion Technology. These institutes have a wonderful campus selections, right? And the salary will vary from 6 to 12 lakh per annum. So this is one of the best course for the students offering or wanted to be in this field. Next course is Bachelor of Hotel Management, right, BHM, and it's also called as Hospitality Management, right? That your career will be as an hospitality manager, or you'll be in charge in a 3-star or 5-star hospital hotel, sorry, right? And you can be a chef, you can be a hair hostess, a steward, right? And what you normally do there is, your job will be, you'll be in the hospitality industries, food and beverage preparations, food and beverage services, front office operations and housekeeping operations. These are all the main role of BHM graduates, right? Here, if you become a chef, if you are a good chef, and your prospects will be very high. And of course, air hostess is a different criteria altogether apart from this, right? So, and of course, you can be a steward there. In the aviation sector, right? You can be in the aviation sector, you can be in a cruise, you can be in the resort, right? So you can, it all depends on the your taste, right? So salary varies from 2 to 4 lakh per annum. So initially it will be less, but depending upon the industries that you are in, you can get a very high, fairly high salary with this hospitality management, right? Next is BTTM, Bachelor of Tourism and Travel Management, right? And of course, your role will be either as a tourist guide or a travel agent, and you can be again in the aviation industries or in cruise or in resort, right? Okay, you will manage the resort, right? So your job is a tourist management sector. So you will be in charge of you will be in the aviation management, and important tourisms are ecotourism and adventure tourism. These are the two important tourisms which are there at present, right? That is really taking it is there in the mainstream, right? So tourism economics, so you will be dealing with that. So this is another area which has not been explored to greater extent in this country, because the tourism sector, right, though it is one of the best country, right, so it has not been explored to a greater extent. So initial salary is not very high, it is 1.2 to 2.2 lakhs per annum. But as you progress, then there is a possibility of fairly high salary.
And there was one wonderful organization which is very good, which was taken care of travel sector, right? That is Thomas Cook. Unfortunately, it is closed quite recently. So these are all the main courses that could be that can be taken after 12th, even if you are in from arts, science, or commerce stream. Right? So Bachelor of Design is my pet course. In this slide, I will give the sectors. I will give the web portals that gives more extensive information about these courses. Bachelor of Design. So NID I mentioned, NID, National Institute of Design. This is what is the education that are there, what is the bachelor degree and other degrees that you can obtain from this National Institute of Design. So that can be obtained from this. And next is National Institute of Fashion Technology. So these two are the very premier institutes of India, right? There are other private organizations which are running this course, right? And this will tell you which are the best colleges in India for Bachelor of Design, right? So this Quora is one of the best web portal site where you can find the details about it. And in this case, people who are already in that field or who have worked in that field or who are in this field will be sharing their experiences. It is basically first-hand information about that industry. Next is here in this case, you will come to know the best design schools which are there in the country, right, in other parts of the countries also, right? So this is will tell you the top ranking institutes on this Bachelor of Design. And this will tell you what can I do with the bachelor's degree, right? So what is the career aspects, prospects that can be obtained from this portal. Next is, this is what is the scope for the bachelor in the design. So that can be obtained from this web portal. So this will tell you the scope of this bachelor design as a career. Next, this will tell you the pay scale of that is salary of a person, right? What is the initial salary and what will be the different jobs that can be obtained after this degree. So that can be obtained from this web portal. And this will tell you about what are the different courses in the different parts of the world and what is the work culture that you can come to know from this web portal, right? So this will tell you about the prospects in Australia. This is Griffith University, right? What are the bachelor degree, how it has been offered there. And this Australia is one of the countries that you can think about for the migration. Next, Bachelor of Hotel Management, right? So this is this will tell you which are the best colleges for the hotel management courses, right? This Quora will give this this web portal. This link will tell you about the best colleges for the hotel management courses, and this will also tell the top 10 management schools, which will hotel management schools in the world, right? Different parts of the world, including Switzerland, Italy, UK, Hungary, right? So different parts, how they are how it is placed with the top 10 management hotel management schools. Details can be obtained from this web link, and this also tells about the hotel management as a career, whether it is good and how it is there, what are their experiences. Here the people who are in this sector has shared their experiences, and here it will tell you the subjects and what are the different universities which are teaching this Bachelor of Hotel Management in UK, US, and Europe, right? So that you can get it from this portal. Here, hotel management as a career, right? How it is that you can get from this website. And in this website, what is the starting salary for the hotel management? And of course, you can find some of the bad experiences of the people also. Of course, that could be personal to them, right? So there are cases where in which the person has got 5,900 rupees as a salary. And immediately after 40 or 1 month or 2 months, it quit the job and change the profession, right? So this is not to discourage you, but to make you to appraise about the possibilities in this field. Next, what are the possibility of recruitments, the career aspects that you can get it from there, and also salary part. Then for the BITTM, so this is Chandigarh College, right? This is one of the best college admissions, right? So this will tell you about the tourism and travel courses after 12th, right? So what are the courses? So this get my university will tell you about this, and what are the prospects, what I can do with my degree of tour travel and tourism, right? What are the career aspects, what is the career possibilities that can be obtained from this website, and the Bachelor of Tourism and Travel Management, and again the details for that will be obtained, and what are the career options. This is another, again here in this Quora, the people have shared their experiences about the field, about this course, so that you can get it from this. And this will tell you about the salary part, so what are the salary involved in it that can be obtained from it. And this will tell you about the our possibilities of this course in the world arena. So these are all the web portals, websites, right? So with this you can get much more information about these courses, which will appraise you more, and from that you can get very good information about these courses. So this is a humble effort to make you to realize what you are doing and what are your future prospects that can be easily visualized to certain extent.
Hi friends, I hope the content of this video is more useful to you and also to your friends. So if so, please like this video by hitting a thumbs up button and share with your friends by hitting this button. My next video is here, the title is here, that is a course after 12th or second QC without a minimum marks and paying high salary is actuaries. So actuaries is a profession. Please type this in a search place of the YouTube and get this video. And the beauty of this course and this profession is this profession can be chosen, or this course can be chosen by any students, either science or arts or commerce students, and further there is no minimum marks requirement for this course. Yet it will pay you very high salary, not only in India, it is also in other countries as well. So please watch this video and get more information. So if you have any questions, please ask in comment section, and then I request you to hit this button and subscribe. So this helps me a lot, and with this I thank you all for your nice hearing. Thank you. I am Dr. Kumar.